Hello and welcome all the students. Today I'm going to teach you paper number 301, which is entitled as Plant Diversity. In this paper, I'm going to teach you unit number 2, which is on fungi. As you already know, and as you can already see on your screen, this unit on fungi is divided into 3 different sections. First is ultrastructure of fungal cell. As you already know, the definition of cell is structural and functional unit of any form of the life, so as fungi. Second one is life history of following genus, which is here in your syllabus. There are 2 different kinds of species we are going to study, is Aspergillus and Saccharomyces. Third and very important topic is industrial application of above mentioned species, which is Aspergillus and Saccharomyces. Here we can study how this Aspergillus and Saccharomyces is used in industry for developing various application in various products, which is used for humankind. Before going to start your 301 fungi chapter, we can travel back through time in your first semester, where you already studied a fungi and their general character. Today we are going to revise your first semester syllabus first, and then come to our this semester syllabus. So first of all, we are going to study a general characteristics of fungi. So when you heard a term fungi, the first question which arises in your mind is, what are fungi? Second one, how fungi is different from other plants. So fungi, which is a Latin word fungus, literally means a mushroom. As you already aware about a mushroom, in this rainy season, we can find many type of mushroom around us. They are eukaryotic organisms. As you already know, what is the difference between prokaryotic organisms and eukaryotic organisms? With 2 nucleus and membrane bound organelle. Here, they are with 2 nucleus and they are membrane bound organelle. So, it is a major character of eukaryotic organism. All the eukaryotic organisms have membrane bound organelle. It means that organelle is surrounded by a membrane or cell wall, which is used for their protection. Role of this membrane or cell wall is to protect particular type of organelle in eukaryotic organisms. Fourth one, they are non-vascular cryptogams. They are non-vascular. They don't have vascular system with them. So they are non-vascular. They cannot synthesize their food. They cannot absorb water. So they are non-vascular cryptogams, including in halophyta, along with algae and lichen. As you already studied about algae and lichen, they are thallophytic organisms. They consist of thallus structure in their body. So they are called as thallophyta. Have undifferentiated plant body, which is also a characteristics of thallophytic organism. Their plant body is not divided into the organelles. So they call as thallophyta. Study of fungi is called as mycology. Latin word myca means fungus. Kingdom fungi is including about 5,100 genera and 50,000 species. Fungi are heterotrophs since they lack a chlorophyll. As we already know, chlorophyll is responsible for food synthesis in any kind of plant or in autotrophic organism. Here, fungi is lacking a chlorophyll, so they are heterotrophs, which means they cannot synthesize their own food, which means they are dependent on other for their food or nutrient requirements. Fungi cannot synthesize their own carbohydrate, which means they cannot synthesize food, because for synthesis of carbohydrate, any organism can require chlorophyll. Here, fungi lack a chlorophyll, so they are heterotrophs. Plant body consisting of thallus makeups of hypha, which together consisting of mycelium. In previous slide, we study, which is, it is a thallophytic organism. So that thallus is made up of two different type of thing. One is hypha and second is mycelium. Hypha is hair-like structure or strain-like structure, which together, come together, many different type of hypha come together and form a mycelium, and this thallus is called as mycelium. So much diversity in form, structure, and method of reproduction. As we already see in this slide, in first line, there were 50,000 species. So they are diverse in form, structure, and matter of reproduction. Fungi are cosmopolitan in distribution, occur in any habitat. Here, word cosmopolitan, as I already taught you in first semester, what is meaning of cosmopolitan? So, any living organism which is found in any form of environment is called as cosmopolitan. So fungi are cosmopolitan in distribution. We can find fungi in any type of environment. So they are cosmopolitan, occur in any habitats. Some fungi are aquatic, which may be fresh water or in marine water. Most of the fungi are terrestrial. We can find this type of fungi on land surfaces. Many species of fungi are parasite to plants. They are dependent on plant and human and animals. Majority of disease of cultivated plants are caused by fungi, and thereby they have immense economic importance. Next one, what is mycelium and what are hypha? We already studied a thallus structure, which is made up of hypha and mycelium. Plant body of fungi typically consists of branch and filamentous hypha. The hypha form net-like structure called mycelium. More than one hypha come together and make a net-like structure, which we can call as mycelium. Hypha may be septate, without a septa, or with a septate, which is called as septate hypha. In aseptic form, hypha will be co-inocyte, which is multinucleated condition. In septate forms, hypha may be uninucleated, which is one nucleated, or binucleated, or rarely a multinucleated. So here, septate forms and aseptate forms are differentiated on the basis of their nucleated conditions. Septate usually simple pore at center from cell to cell communication. Septa, which means a structure or a teeny organ which is responsible for cell to cell communication. How fungal cell wall is different from the cell wall of other plants? Here we can see the how fungal cell wall, which is different from plant cell wall. Protoplast of fungi is surrounded by distinct cell wall. In slime mode, which is a lower form of the fungi closely related to the protista, the cell wall is absent in slime mold, which is a type of fungi. The cell wall is absent. It is a rare example. Main component of cell wall is chitin, a major difference of fungal cell wall from plant cell wall. Plant cell wall contains cellulose, and here fungal cell wall contains chitin. Chitin is polymer of an acetyl glucosamine, a derivative of glucose. In lower fungi, cell wall is composed of cellulose and glycan, which is similar to the plant cell wall. How mitosis in fungi is different from other eukaryotes? Nucleus of fungi is very small. Fungi have special type of mitosis called as nuclear mitosis. Mitosis in fungal cell is different from that of other eukaryotic. In fungi, during mitotic cell division, nuclear envelope does not break down. Generally, in eukaryotic organism, during a mitosis, nuclear envelope is break down and again reform. Instead of mitosis take place within a nucleus. In the fungal cell, mitotic division is take place within a cell. It is not going to break a nuclear envelope. Spindle apparatus is formed within a nucleus which drag the chromosome to two opposite poles of nucleus, not the cell, as in most case of eukaryotes. What is meant by dikaryotization? Fungal hypha may be homokaryotic. Homokaryotic means only one strand of nuclei, or heterokaryotic. Two different strand of nuclei is present, then it's called as heterokaryotic. If one, then it's called as homokaryotic. Hypha may be haploid, diploid, or dikaryotic. Dikaryotic condition is seen in higher form of fungi, only member of Ascomycetes or Basidiomycetes. In dikaryotic mycelium, two different strain of nuclei, positive and negative. This strain is called as positive strain, and the other called as a negative strain, stay separately in the cell, and they stimulously divide when cell is divided. In the cell, two kind of the strain, one is positive, another is negative. They both are separate from each other, and when the cell division occurs, these two different strands are divided separately. The process of formation of dikaryotic mycelium is called as a dikaryotization. What are the hyphal modification in fungi? The majority of fungi hypha are simple. Some advanced fungi hypha may undergo certain modification in response to their functional need. If fungal cell wall needs some particular type of the function, there one of the hypha will be modified. The important hyphal modification in fungi are example prosenchyma, pseudoparenchyma, rhizomorphs, sclerotia, etc. What is the type of nutrition in fungi? Fungi are heterotrophic in nutrition because they lack a chlorophyll. They do not manufacture their food. They do not manufacture the carbohydrate. So they are dependent on other organisms. So they are called as heterotrophic for the nutrition. Fungi are entirely devoid of chlorophyll. However, they have carotenoid and other color pigment are present. But they are only there for their color pigmentation. They cannot synthesize food or any type of the carbohydrate. On the basis of made of nutrition, fungi classified into three different groups. First is parasitic, grow and feed on other living plant and animal. On saprophytes, grow and feed on that organic matter. Symbiotins, mutual association between algal or roots of higher plants like an mycorrhiza are the example. Next, an important question about fungi, how fungi reproduce. Fungi reproduce by vegetative, sexual and asexual matter. Sexual state of fungi is called telomorph. Asexual state of fungi is called as anamorph. Vegetative reproduction in fungi take place by fragmentation. As you already know, fragmentation, which is the simplest type of reproduction, by fissions and by budding. It's seen in yeast cells. About 20% of fungi, mostly member of Neuromycetes, propagate only by asexual means, completely like asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction takes place during favorable condition by formation of variety of conidia or spores. Fungal spores may be unicellular or multicellular. Spore may be endogenous when enveloped in sporangia, or they may be exogenous when developed on sporophore or conidiospore. Common asexual spore of fungi are zoospore, conidiospore, chlamydiospore and oida. In lower fungi, reproductive cells are lagellated and motile for reason for their reproduction. Flagella are two types in fungi, wispal and pincer. Smooth flagella with 9+2 organization is called as wispal, and flagella with numerous minute hair-like production called as a mistogonemus, originated from axial filaments, is called as pincer flagella. Motile reproductive structure are completely absent in higher form of the fungi. How sexual reproduction occur in fungi? This is last. Process of sexual reproduction is complete in three distinct stages: plasmogamy, karyogamy, and meiosis. Fusion of cytoplasm is called as plasmogamy. Fusion of nucleus is called as karyogamy. Reduction division, when number of chromosomes are going to reduce in the process, is called as reduction division, which is known as meiosis. In higher plant of fungi, plasmogamy do not immediately follows karyogamy. Cell will hold the two nucleus separately in order to stabilize dikaryotization. So that's all for today. In next lecture, we are going to study about ultrastructure of fungal cell wall. So then, take care. Bye.